Hi everyone, this is Vinay Sharma from Raise the Bar with DS, and in this session or in this video we will discuss how to use the rest of the model. In the previous video we had done how to use models and the usages of will and shall, and we also came to know about the concept of notions. And notions are some ideas that you express when you speak in special terms. Fine. So today we'll see the usages of would, should and other models. So first let's take would. Would in sentences expresses following ideas. Preference oblique liking. Yes, second one, in would rather clauses. Third, habitual action in past, in place of used to, to make request or polite request. Okay, so these are the various different usages of would. Would simply means would simply means preferability or your choice or your liking. And one more usage of would is in imaginary condition. Conditional sentences. Okay, let's look at the examples. I would like to introduce myself.
Sir, yes. There is some voice while you typing, sir.
Voice?
Yes, sir. Unwanted voice. While you type something.
While I type, I should not speak.
No, sir. Your voice is clear, but there is some noise while you type.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
There is some noise while I type. Okay. I would like to introduce myself. Here you can say preference or liking. Fine. Another example, preference. I would rather die than beg. I would prefer over coffee. When I was young, I would play football for us. Now look at the example of imaginary condition. If I were a bird, I would fly high in the sky. If I were a billionaire, I would travel the world on my chartered plane. And let's see some example of request. Would you help me, please? Would you mind shifting a little aside? Or you can say shifting aside a little. Would you mind? Would you be kind enough to help me with this? Arithmetic problem. Would you mind? So these are the examples of would as a model. So would as model expresses preference. Your preference. First use of would is you are expressing what you want, what your choice is, and what you like. What your likings are, what your will are, what your will is, and what your preference is. You may prefer something over some other thing. So I would like to introduce, I would like to go for it, I would like to say something, I would like to make a decision, I would like to make a declaration. And some of our actions are that we are now old, but there was a time when we used to be young. And in that age, we used to perform many activities on a daily basis, routine basis. So if you are referring your past habits in present, then you will use would as model there. You will replace used to by would. If in any sentence you see used to, then you will replace it with would. And imaginary condition and request. You know how to make request and you know how to make an imaginary conditional sentence. If I were a bird, if I were a billionaire, if I were the prime minister, if I were the king, if I were the superman, if I had superpowers. So all these imaginations, you can make your imaginative statements by using would. Is that clear here? Or do you remember any other extra usage of would, then let me know. If I have forgotten to tell you something about would, then you let me know. Okay. And also in imaginary condition and impossible condition as well. So let me give you some more, one or two example of impossible condition as well. You know, so So let's take this impossible condition as well. If or
maybe we can use would say past.
What?
We can use would for past.
Would for past. Good. Had yes. I worked hard. Had I worked hard for my exams, I would have been passed. I would have been passed the exam. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Fine. If she had taken her doctor's advice, she would have been alive today.
She wanted a divorce, but his wife would not agree.
क्यों शी की वाइफ कैसे होएगी मतलब मैं समझा नहीं लेस्बियन कपल है क्या
आई मीन ही वांटेड अ डिवोर्स बट हिज वाइफ वुड नॉट एग्री
शी वांटेड अ डिवोर्स बट हिज ओके मतलब थ्री इधर डबल लव लो थ्री ट्रायंगल लव ट्रायंगल इज देयर यू नो यस ओके गुड द स्टेटमेंट इज गुड फाइन सो लेट्स लुक एट शुड Now let's come to should. So should as model auxiliary expresses advisability. Or what is commendable or most suitable course of action. Fine. So should as model expresses mean what you should do, what is the best suitable course of action that you should take or you should do. Okay, so first point of should is advice. Second point is suggestion. Third point is advice, suggestion, counseling, counsel. Fourth point is in place of had better. Whenever in a sentence you look at had better, you can replace the phrase by using should. In lest clauses. If last adverb is there in a sentence, then in the next conjugation you will use should lest clauses. It is a fixed rule. Lest ke baad hamesha should aata hai. Lest ke baad hamesha should aata hai. It's a fixed rule. Okay, don't forget it. Advice, suggestion, counsel, moral duty. Or you can say unpaid duty. And what more you can suggest about should, if you remember anything, let me know. Past tense of shall. Or bataiye, and you can tell me one more. Advisability, suggestion, counsel, in place of had better, in last clauses, moral duty, unpaid duty, past tense of shall. Yes,
conditional,
yes.
Conditional, sir.
In conditional sentences,
what do you say? If else.
In imaginary conditional, imaginary conditional sentences, but with a specific meaning, a specific reference. It depends on the meaning. Where mostly we use would in conditional sentences. Mostly and generally, most generally we use would in conditional sentences. But in some sentences with meaning, you will use should, can have, would have, could have, should have, will have, shall have. You can also use. So it's not a very very strong rule or a strong recommendation to use should in imaginary condition. Okay, and then you suggest me some other meaning of this sentence. Okay, so let's look at the examples of the sentence. This test, examples. You should take proper rest before taking any step further on your startup idea, you should take proper consulting. Yeah, you can say proper guidance from senior people. We should obey our elders everyone should help the needy. Everyone should help the needy. Okay. You had better take care of my words next time. Means you will remove had better. You should take care of my words next time. Run fast, lest you should miss the train. Who is this? Run fast lest you should miss the train. Work hard lest you should fail the exam. Okay, so these are the usages of should. Is it clear? I hope you have got would and should.
Yes, sir.
Have you or do you have any doubts about them? Do you let me know?
No, sir. Yes, sir.
These are simple notions, and you should be very much careful about the notions what the models express. Now we take can. Can as model. Can is a model. We should not write can as model. Okay. Can means can simply means your capability of doing something, or you can say qualification is the better word hai ki qualification. Qualification or eligibility. Fine. So the words of can are first one. Ability. Capability. Capacity. Okay, then can to give or take permission. To give or take permission. To make a request. Let me write informal. Then with the verbs of perception, like see, hear, feel, listen, taste and smell. With the verbs of perception, ability, capability, capacity, to give or take permission, to make a request, informal, with the verbs of perception, can you suggest some more usage of can, or let's have this only.
Can अपन past के लिए भी use कर सकते
हैं। Can is not used for past. Can is used for present. Strength or might. Strength, fine. Or physical strength. We can say physical strength. Physical or mental strength.
पर जैसे ये example जो can.
Okay, let's look at the examples of the sentence. Okay, the meaning is clear now. There's nothing much about this tense to tell, this model to tell you about. So she is able to write and speak with fluency. You can write she can write and speak with fluency. Beam is strong enough to carry this heavy box. So you can write it, rewrite it. Beam can carry this heavy box. The son of the owner is capable of running the organization towards new heights of success. So you can write, the son of the owner can run the organization, can run the organization towards the new heights of success. Okay, and you can also use them with the verbs of perception. Then you, the sentence example of verbs of perception is, I can see, feel, and I can see, feel, and you know, I can see and feel your pain. I can see and feel your pain. She can smell trickery in your words. She can smell trickery on in your words. Can I touch you like this? Can you tell me where the Mehta bookstore is? Request, it's a request. Can I use your railway timetable? Ye permission hai. Can you tell me where the Mehta bookstore is? You are asking somebody to, you are requesting somebody to tell you where the particular bookstore is, or in the next sentence you are asking somebody to allow you to use his railway timetable or map or whatever. So is it clear? Can is clear to you or not? Okay. Let's take one more model today. Could. Could simply means, one simply means usages, past tense of can. Past tense of can. Past form of can. Only one usage of could. Past tense of can. I wish I could tell you, I could show you how strong I am, how strong I am, but I'm too. I'm too old now. If you had met me 10 years back in time, 10 years back in time, I could show you my skills at swimming. So could only has one usage, and which is past tense of can. So today we have done would, should, can, could. I hope you got them. I hope you have understanding now, clear understanding of how to use these models in your expressions. Models are mood showing denotative verbs that impart beauty and brevity to your spoken English and to your expression. And we should quite frequently use them in our language. Okay, so thank you very much.